हरे कृष्ण। थैंक यू महाराज। सो महाराज इज सेटिंग ए नाइस एग्जाम्पल हियर। सो दो वी आर सीटिंग टुगेदर टिल महाराज इज वेरी वेरी सीनियर डिसिपल ऑफ श्री प्रभुपाद स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर, बट आई मीन बाई हिज ओन एग्जाम्पल ही इज टीचिंग अस हाउ वी शुड गिव रेस्पेक्ट टू अवर कृष्ण। So I am very junior analysis. So so regarding Srila Prabhupada, since we are celebrating this wonderful festival, as we heard from Maharaj and Srila Prabhupada was mentioning, in the outside world, so people sometimes they wonder how this Krishna consciousness people, they are crazy, no? So they are celebrating if, when the person dies. So sometimes they don't understand how these people are celebrating. There is in their dictionary, there is no such type of celebration when the person dies. Because that is also correct, because that person is so ordinary, there is nothing to celebrate, no, when he dies. Because outside people, they have not done anything great. In one sense, it is correct also. They are not celebrating. But in our Vaishnava tradition, so the Vaishnava, when they leave the body, of course, we have some lamentation because we are missing their physical presence. And the audience, association, everything we are missing, there is a lamentation. But same times also we have celebrating the joy, because they are victory over this material energy, the Maya. Because in the glorious pastime, they have done so much actually glorious activities in their and when they are in this material world, and also they saved so many living entities, those who are entangled in this material world. So that's why to remembering those glories, so we are celebrating their disappearance. Hare Krishna Srila Prabhupada, because I have not personally met Srila Prabhupada. So, but we have been very much fortunate to be with Srila Prabhupada's mission. Actually, I came to Krishna Conscious Movement by reading Srila Prabhupada's book. That was Srila Prabhupada's pastime, that condensed volume. It was in English. Somebody gave to my father, when they are distributing books, my father gave some donation, so he gave that book. But they don't read English, so they kept in their self, bookshelf. So when I found there is a book, Prabhupada's bald head, and I was remembered, oh, this is there must be some saintly person, so let's read it. Actually, in the beginning part, that touches me most in the Prabhupada's pastime, and his determination. So though actually we are not devotees, but since a little background of devotional, so you understood some saintly person, how they do, they are completely determined in their spiritual master's mission. And I was very surprised when Prabhupada was approaching the Sumati Maharaji. So anyhow he wants to go USA. So in the modern world, people may think that, oh, because is now the fashion in this world, in Indian people, they want to go USA for doing something else. But this person with the 69-year-old, he wants to go USA for what purpose? He has not any material desire to see the USA, the big buildings. Or he want to enjoy this different sightseeing in the USA. He has not that desire. So I was completely shocked actually in that when I was reading that book. How this person is so much dedicated himself for the only cause of the fulfilling the desire of his spiritual master. So when I was reading that pastime Srila Prabhupada, and also and when he was embarking his journey in the ocean by Jaljuta, so he got two massive heart attacks, but still he was not deviated from his path. So in our case, in ordinary people, suppose we get something like that, so we have to think about that, our mission. Yeah. Even we have been actually endowed with so much facilities, when you are going to Western countries for preaching or other things, everything is arranged for us nowadays. Devotees are there in airport, devotees are taking care of your prasadam, everything, that thing. But there is nothing was arranged for Prabhupada, no? And there is no health insurance, no? That somebody will take care. But still Prabhupada is so much dependent, so much surrendered to the Krishna and his spiritual master. So that actually touched me when I... Then I thought definitely I should see this person, where is this person living. So that was the inquiry came in my heart. So I must see this person. In those days there was... I was in Bhubaneswar, so there is no Bhubaneswar center address was there, because that is English book, no? There Bombay address was there. So it was far from that place. Then I was again attracted by seeing the Srila Prabhupada's the song he wrote in the Jaladutta. So actually the person, sometimes we get so much popped up in our own enthusiastic or own activities, and oh, we must do this thing, we'll do this thing. But Prabhupada was so humility, Prabhupada was showing in that song, no? So how he was so much surrendered to Krishna. That's why Krishna came to his aid. And also we see in those days actually, so it was considered actually, that's why Prabhupada is called the founder acharya, as Maharaj mentioned. Founder acharya is not mentioned, not meaning that a certain guru, because he is the founding element of a certain religious principle. Because in your religious principle in India, so there was not mentioned that some sadhu or any religious person to surpass the ocean. It was abandoned actually in your religious, in Hindu religion practice. But Prabhupada established that principle actually. So there is no such restriction actually for the saintly person to go or the cross the ocean. Because when you are surrounded by this ocean of the India, in your religious tradition, as we heard from the previous people, when you cross the ocean from the Indian, so you consider the Mlecha, no? Yeah. Because there is an untouchable area, they can't consider. You see, Prabhupada surpassed those things, no? And who could imagine that the women could come to this Krishna consciousness? In those days, they were abandoned, they were forbidden. Even Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he did not have much women disciple. But Srila Prabhupada, he surpassed that, those things, because that's why he called founder acharya, no? We should understand this thing. And sometimes it comes to a confusion of many devotees. What did Prabhupada, did anything wrong? So we should not keep in their mind this thing, because this is like a small poison in your mind sometimes. Because Prabhupada understood actually what is the Vedic principle very clearly, he understood. And the philosophy of Bhagavad Gita, he understood where is the, we are beyond the bodies, you know. So there's a, everybody has the equal right for this Krishna consciousness movement. So why other person, why only the man can be only Krishna conscious, woman cannot? So that's why Prabhupada said they have equal right in Krishna consciousness. So so that's why sometimes it contradicts the Vedic religion, but Prabhupada established the Vedic religion, Satchila Prabhupada. And as Maharaj was mentioning, Prabhupada has so much humor actually. So I had a good fortune with meeting some Prabhupada's disciple that I was asking last GBC meeting time. How you become so much attracted to Prabhupada, I was asking them. Then in the answer there I was saying that Prabhupada has so much love for us. He was taking care of so much personally towards us. And also when we see when Prabhupada came back from USA, the third time he had a heart attack and he came back to India for recovery, and when he went back to USA, so he had so much gift for the devotees, for personal. So he was giving the ladies for the saris and dhotis, because in the Western world you don't get it in those days. Now of course due to ISKCON we have in many shops, they don't get actually those things. Because Prabhupada had so much personal feeling, that Prabhupada thinks that they are my son and daughters. So that's why the Prabhupada has a natural love for them. They are not saying, oh, they are my disciples, no? Because I am the spiritual master, I will take only enjoyment, no, for them service. And equally, Prabhupada was also trying to serve them. Like we saw, the Prabhupada has a tear in his eyes. Prabhupada was chuckled, he could not speak in the language because he has so much. He was thinking he completely indebted to his disciples. Because those disciples, they helped him to propagate his spiritual master's vision. Because his spiritual master ordered him to go out to the English-speaking world. And the, his disciples, they are helping. That's why Prabhupada was saying that I am indebted of you and you are my spiritual disciple, my spiritual master. So you are the representative of my spiritual master. So that love and affection actually reciprocates. Even Prabhupada, not only disciples, outside people also. As I was remember when in 1996 when I was in Calcutta, so there was a big scientist camp for that conference actually, in Prabhupada's centennial conference. So he is just a scientist. But he was completely taken away from Prabhupada's behavior and his eye. Though we heard many times Prabhupada said that the scientists are rascals, but that scientist, he was glorifying Sri Prabhupada when he heard about the he is a rascal. So when Prabhupada was in Los Angeles temple, so that scientist is Benford, as you might have heard in a self-relation book, that is a conversation of Sri Prabhupada with that scientist. So I saw that scientist in. So so he was speaking about Srila Prabhupada actually in that conference. In just in Los Angeles temple, there is a Prabhupada park. So they used to sit together. And just before their conversation, Prabhupada was chastising him heavily. You scientists, the rascal scientists, you are misleading the people and this thing, that thing, the Prabhupada was chastising heavily. And when he came, just finishing their talking, and one devotee, Prabhupada disciple, came with a big Mahaprasadam to Prabhupada and his silver plate. And what Prabhupada did? Prabhupada told, this Benford, this is for you. So he was completely shocked, that person. He completely changed his mind. Because he just before he got chastisement from Prabhupada, and now he's seeing the different way of, another way of that person, same person. He is such a person, he has so much love for me. And what is meant for him, and he is giving to me those things. In Western world, actually, you don't see that this type of natural love. Even the parents, they don't give that type of love to the people. So that's why they are completely like sold out, no, to Prabhupada when I see this thing. So he was narrating that story that how he was completely taken away by his Prabhupada's love for him. And that Mahaprasadam, he was so much fond of Mahaprasadam, and he was taking that Mahaprasadam. And the end also, he told one of the disciples of Prabhupada, so can you pack that eggplant sabji, no? Because he was a love of eggplant sabji. So like that, still Prabhupada is like it so much, he never compromised the philosophy, as Maharaj mentioned also. And same time, he has so much love and humor for the others. So not like that, oh, means I am. So I am guru and whatever I say, that is 100%, no? And he was asking many times the devotees, so what is your suggestion? His disciples, no, he was asking. So what do you think? And many times when Brahmananda Prabhu was explaining the past time in Vrindavan, 2-3 years back before. So when some property was supposed to buy, and then he was asking those, what is your suggestion? What do you think about this price and this thing, that thing? And somebody may think that Prabhupada doesn't know how to do, then why he is asking his disciples? Now Prabhupada, Prabhupada is sharing his wonderful loving exchange to his sharing among his disciples. So they will not think that, oh, we have been completely ignored, no? So that's why we see that behavior and also Srila Prabhupada's activities. So whatever actually we read in strict scripture sometimes, what is the central person, their quality, other things, we read in scripture sometimes in our mental speculation or intelligence. We sometimes think, oh, this central person may be like this, may be like this. But here is a person who is living example in front of us. And his own activities, he is showing all the examples, what are the good qualities of a central person. And he is living among the hippies. Sometimes also he is talking with those persons who are completely established in this material world, big persons. And sometimes Srila Prabhupada also teaching them how to make chapati, no? Such things. And so in those days in the 66, when Prabhupada went, and even the devotees, those who are living with Srila Prabhupada, they did not know how to clean their plate after the prasadam. They just eat prasadam and go away. And Prabhupada used to clean their plate. Prabhupada never think that, oh, I am and in case of us, what do we think? We think that, oh, we have been devotees for a long time. Why I should clean the plate of another devotee? And they are not devotees also. They are just like Maharaj said, they are hippies just in a Bavari. They are living in the Bavari area just. And they go away. And Prabhupada clean the pots and cooking pots, everything Prabhupada cleaning and keeping for the next day. In the 50th century, Srila Saptur Maharaj, he was telling this past time how. So he came to Krishna consciousness, he became more attached to Srila Prabhupada. So he was not the devotee, he was just regular visiting Srila Prabhupada and taking only prasadam. And one day he was late from his work, Saswarup Maharaj. So he was working in that. So one day he was late. Then he called, in those days they called Swamiji. Swami, can you serve me a plate of food stuff for me? Because I have to go late. My work is late. And after everybody ate, and Prabhupada served a plate. And when he came in the late, like 4 o'clock, Prabhupada gave him plates. Surprised, how the person, I have no connection with this person. And he has so much concern for me, and he is having a plate for me, prasadam. And he is waiting for me also. Prabhupada is supposed to take rest actually after prasadam, but Prabhupada is waiting when that part. So those personal relation exchange actually love. So that actually bounded in those 60 devotees actually. That's why they did wonders actually in this. Nobody could do actually So in the history, actually, it will be written in the actually in the history in the future. Like now we are studying actually the pastime of Sist Goswami and other things. So we don't know after 50 years or 100 years, will you read actually Srila Prabhupada's those pastimes in your history, Indian history. And those devotees that did actually the wonders actually, nobody could think about that, how they could spread only 5 months a devotee or 1 month a devotee, they can go and open a center. How could they get this much power in and confidence in their so when we joined the ISKCON, we have like 6 month new devotee course, 6 month then sankirtan, this thing, that thing, then we have to be 4-5 years under certain guidance of temple. Then if our devotee temple commander says, oh, you go and preach, give some class, then we get scared, no? Now we are not that much confidence to go to some other place. But those devotee only 2 months. When the first group of devotee, they went to San Francisco, they were only 2 months devotee, no? Only 2 months. And they did not have any address to where to go, San Francisco, to open the center. And they did not have any sufficient money also to buy the ticket. They just send, they are in the street. So they have to catch the bus or flight, they have to go to San Francisco and open the center. And when they went, and they got success. Because they had also same type of confidence like Srila Prabhupada has confidence on his spiritual master. That's why in our Krishna consciousness actually very important. We have to full faith, complete faith and surrender to our spiritual masters, his word and his mission. Then only actually we get success as we see in Srila Prabhupada's life and also his disciples. So they, when Prabhupada told that, you see, my disciples, you see, they are household disciples. They did such wonder, even Prabhupada's god brother, those who are sannyasi, they could not fulfill those things. Can you imagine those things? Sannyasi they cannot fulfill, and only household, there are only 3 couples, no? Because Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur also, he sent his sannyasi disciples to England to preach the Krishna consciousness. But they could not fulfill that desire. But the same desire, still Prabhupada, only 3 householder couples, they fulfill that desire. No? So how could it happen? No? So sometimes in our small mind, we cannot think that how it happens. But something was working underneath, actually, inside something is working. So that those who have completely surrendered to the Supreme Lord and his pure devotees, Srila Prabhupada, like, so they can only achieve this type of wonders, actually. So this is actually wonders, actually. This cannot be performed, actually, in a material platform. And you see, Prabhupada's age was like 69 when he embarked the journey, and only 11 years, only span of 11 years. And he spread all over the world, this Krishna consciousness. And it is such a like old age and a deteriorating body. And he was traveling also. And sometimes he was writing also thousands of letters. And he was also translating the books. It is not like a human being that is certain doing, something doing. If he practice also, Srila Prabhupada's lifestyle and others, he cannot do, he just get sick after 1 or 2 months. So he cannot imitate, because Srila Prabhupada was completely empowered by the Supreme Lord to do this activity for Krishna. As Maharaj told also, this we should not be like happy that our Prabhupada made this arrangement nice, this thing, no? Still there are so many places. The still people, they don't know what is the Krishna consciousness movement is. লাইসি চৈতন্য মহাপ্রভু সে ফোরকাস্ট পৃথিবী পৃথিবীতে আছে যেত নগর আদি গ্রাম, সো এভরি টাউন অ্যান্ড কন্ট্রি সমটাইমস দো দিস ইজ অলরেডি প্রপাগেটেড বাট স্টিল দেয়ার ইজ মেনি প্লেসেস সো পিপল ডে ডোন্ট নো হোয়াট ইজ কৃষ্ণ কনসিয়াসনেস. ইভেন লাস্ট ইয়ার আই ওয়াজ ইন সাউথ আফ্রিকা, আই ওয়েন্ট লিটল ইনসাইড এমরলো, দেয়ার ইজ ওয়ান ট্রাইবাল এরিয়া, সো দে জাস্ট গট স্ট্রেঞ্জ টু সিইং লাইক দিস টাইপ অফ ড্রেস, দে ডোন্ট নো হোয়াট ইজ দিস পিপুল আর মেন্ট ফর. সো কৃষ্ণ কনসিয়াস দে ডোন্ট কমপ্লিটলি দে আর কমপ্লিটলি ইগনোরেন্ট, দে ডোন্ট নো হোয়াট ইজ কৃষ্ণ কনসিয়াসনেস. সো লাইক দ্যাট দে আর সো মেনি প্লেসেস ইন দিস ওয়ার্ল্ড অলসো. So that is the duty of all of us, Srila Prabhupada's followers. And we have been so much fortunate, now we have so many wonderful Srila Prabhupada's disciples, those who have completely actually have body to body physical association with Srila Prabhupada. And we should to take their advantages and take their association and take whatever possibility from them. What love Srila Prabhupada gave them and what they had for Prabhupada, then we should take that advantages and we should embark in that journey and go for preaching this, spreading this mission of Srila Prabhupada. And in this disappearance day actually particularly, so we should completely meditate on Srila Prabhupada like Srila Maharaj was advising us. We hear more Srila Prabhupada Katha and Srila Prabhupada's lecture and Srila Prabhupada's pastime, we hear from different Vaishnavas. So that will be like Prabhupada consciousness. So rather I will tell Krishna consciousness. In our ISKCON devotee, we should have Prabhupada consciousness always. Yeah, if you had a Prabhupada consciousness always, then you will not never go wrong. No? Because whatever standard and everything set up by Srila Prabhupada, if we have completely focused on that, in that consciousness, then there will be nothing wrong in your life. So in this day we should pray in the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada, so Prabhupada would give us his mercy little bit, so we can also follow the same footpath what Prabhupada embarked in his life. And our life will become success. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki. Srila Prabhupada Tiroha Mahasav ki. Samvet Bhakta Vrinda ki. Gaur Premanande. Hare Krishna.